bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga, cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside a new Balenciaga. I'm bringing sexy back.
A powerful tool that ships with Node.js is the event emitter. The event emitter is Node.js's implementation of the pub/sub design pattern, and it allows us to create listeners for and emit custom events. So let's take a look at it. We're going to do so in this empty file called app.js. The first thing we'll do is require events here. And then we're going to create emitter and set that equal to a new events.event emitter. Perfect. The next thing we'll do is we're going to use that pattern that we've seen a lot of. We'll say emitter.on. Then we will create a custom event and add a callback function here that's going to log whoever the message and the user is. So here we'll say console log user and message. Excellent. So once we've created this event, we need to emit this event, which we'll do with emitter.emit. We'll use the name of our custom event. We'll use the same string, custom event. And then what we need to pass into this are two things. We need the message and the user. So we'll say hello world, and this user here is a computer. Let's try this again. We're going to copy and paste this. We'll replace hello world. We'll say that's pretty cool. And then the person who said that is Eve. I said that. Perfect. So now we can use process.standardInput.on. Whenever there's some new data, we want to take that data and we want to create an input. We'll say data to string. We'll trim off any white space. Now, if the input that's added is exit, then we're going to emit a custom event called goodbye. That's the message. And the user is the process. And then we'll call process.exit. Nice. And then outside of this, if the input is something else, we'll say emitter.emit custom event. The message will be data.toString.trim. And the user will be the terminal. I'm also noticing here I need to add quotes around the terminal. This is our user. That should be a string, not a variable. So let's try to run this. We'll pop open our terminal. We'll make sure that we're navigated to the right directory and run node app. Our two custom events that we've emitted are found here. So hello world, and that's pretty cool. And then if I type in anything else, this is going to be attributed to our terminal user. So we'll say Node.js is awesome.
mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the richest of them all? Who don't have to choose and who can buy whatever at the mall? Like my money, like my lover's racks, really thick and tall. I've been scoring goals all my life, ain't this even touched crazy. The ball.
Yeah.
This is crazy.
Around the term. The process. Says goodbye and city. Earlier, we had created this collect answers function. And what we want to do next with it is we want to break it down into different modules. The first thing we'll do is inside of the start folder, we will create a new folder called lib. Thank you. Earlier, we had created this collect answers function. And what we want to do next with it is we want to break it down into different modules. The first thing we'll do is inside of the start folder, we will create a new folder called lib. And this is going to be a library folder that will contain other functions that we can use in different places. So here we want to call this collect answers JS. CollectAnswersJS is going to be responsible for housing this CollectAnswers function, which really requires several things. So we're going to start to break down this file. We'll cut everything from line 24 and up and drop it here into the CollectAnswers file. The next thing we'll do is we still want to import readline. We still want to create our interface, but we want to make this consumable by another file. So we're going to replace this function. We'll say module.exports. We'll set this equal to our function. And we'll make this an arrow function. We want to point an arrow directly at what we want to return. Next, we want to, over here in our ask file, we're going to use this module. So we'll say collect answers. We want to pull this in from .lib/collect-answers. This is the name of the file as a module, so we don't need to append JS at the end of it. Now, if I try to run this again, we'll see what is your name, where do you live, Tahoe, what are you going? Perfect. So now this should echo back all of my answers to me. let's make some adjustments to our collect answers function. And the first thing we want to do here is we want to require the event emitter. And we're going to destructure this from the events module. So I only want to use event emitter. I don't have to use events.event emitter every time. Once I've imported this, I can make some adjustments to our function. The first thing we want to do is include the emitter, which will be a new instance of the event emitter, and we'll call that there. And then down here at the end of our function, we want to return the emitter so that we can use it. So now we can use this emitter to raise events when certain things happen within this function. For example, let's say we wanted to raise an event every time the user answered a question. What we can do is say emitter.emit answer with whatever that answer is. So what we can do now over in our ask function, we want to be able to respond to these events from the file. So because our collect answer... answers function now returns an event emitter, what we can do is say const answer events, set that equal to our collect answers function, and then here we're going to call answer events.on. So remember, we need to refer to the string for the event, our custom event called answer, and then we need to provide a function for what to do when this happens. So we'll take in our answer. So we'll take in our answer as an argument and console log the answer is answer. Nice. Let's try running this. We'll type node ask, what's your name? The answer is Eve. Where do you live? Tahoe. The answer is Tahoe. What are you going to do with Node.js? Say a new answer. Modules give us this great way to still get...
Who am I?
Say emitter dot emit answer.
I need to find the answer.
With whatever that answer is.
What you gonna do about it? Hey, yo! What you gonna do about it? We'll be right back.
What you gonna do about it? Hey, yo! What you gonna do about it?
The event, our customs. And now we'll still get all of these done events firing. We will be able, though, to have something happen when we get a new answer. Modules give us this great way to separate and reuse code, and the event emitter gives us a way to handle custom events when they are raised. By using both of these, this great way to separate and reuse code, and the event emitter gives us a way to handle custom events when they are raised. By using both of these tools together with Readline, we've created a pretty cool little Node.js module. In the last chapter, we Node.js also ships with a module that allows us to interact with the file system. The FS module can be used to list files and directories, create files and directories, stream files, change file permissions, and really just about anything you'd need to work with files and directories. To get started, we want to go over to this empty file called list.js, and we want to create an import. So we'll say require FS. From here, we're going to create a variable called files that's going to help us read files into a variable. So we'll say fs.readdir/sync, and we want to read from the directory that we're currently in. Now, if we console log these files and we save and run node list, this is going to give us an array of all of the files that are listed here. Notice that when I read the directory, I used a function called readdir/sync. This means that I read the contents of this directory synchronously with a blocking request, meaning that I'm blocking the rest of the process until the file is read. Now, when we use any methods of the file system module, we are given the option to use them synchronously or asynchronously. So because we're blocking here, a way that we could do this differently is I could say, readdir. We'll still read from the same spot, but this time we're going to pass in a callback function. We'll say error files. Now, if there's some sort of error, we want to throw an error. Otherwise, we'll simply log the files. So check this out. I'll give it a save. I'll get rid of my other console message. And I also want to get rid of the variable that I created here. So now what we can do, run node list again. And our results will be exactly the same. When our app is already running, it's really nice to use these asynchronous requests so that the process can do other things while your file or directory is being read. Now we also want to use these asynchronous of the variable that I created here. So now what we can do, run node list again, and our results will be exactly the same. When our app is already running, it's really nice to use these asynchronous requests so that the process can do other things while your file or directory is being read. Now we also want to, just to prove that this is working, we'll console log reading files. Node list, reading files will happen first. When we're ready reading the files, we'll log the rest here to the console. Files will happen first. When we're ready reading the files, we'll log the rest here to the console after. Reading files is another feature of our FS module. It's going to allow reading files is another feature of our FS module. It's going to allow us to read the contents of a file encoded into some sort of a text format. What we'll do first is we want to continue to import our file system module. Then in order to check this out, we want to take a look over here in our start folder and notice that we have this file called readme.md. It's filled with some lorem ipsum text. We just need to read something, so might as well read some nonsense there. What we'll do here is we want to go ahead and replace the code that we had with a variable called ipsum. Set that equal to read file sync. We're going to read this synchronously. And I'm going to include the name of the file, readme.md, as well as the text encoding format for the file, which is, in most cases for text files, going to be UTF-8. Then we'll go ahead and log this to our console. We should be able to see the contents from our Text file being read out here. There's also an asynchronous counterpart to this function called read file. So just like before, we're going to pass in the name of the file. We're going to pass in UTF-8, but this time, as you might expect, we'll pass in a callback function. The two arguments that are sent here are error and ipsum. This means that we can get rid of the variable that we've created. And this is going to log to our console all of that text. And then finally here, let's say reading the file. This is going to let our users know that the process has begun. Now, what we'll do here is we'll clear this out. We'll run node list. This will happen the same way. So we're reading the file. This time we're reading it async. The process has begun. Now, what we'll do here is we'll clear this out. We'll run node list. This will happen the same way. So we're reading the file. This time we're reading it. The process has begun. Now, what we'll do here is we'll clear this out. We'll run node list. This will happen the same way. So we're reading the file. This time we're reading it asynchronously. When the system has finished retrieving the file's contents, the callback is invoked, allowing our main thread to do. We're reading the file. This time we're reading it asynchronously. When the system has finished retrieving the file's contents, the callback is invoked, allowing our main thread to do something else in the meantime. So up here at the top, we should be able to see reading the file happens first. Once we have the text read, we can go ahead and see it there. The FS module can also be used to write or append data to a file. In this lesson, we'll take a closer look. Let's create a new file here called write file, and we're going to import the file system module, as you might expect, and then we're going to create some markdown. So we're going to create a little template here. We'll say let md equal, we'll use a couple backtick, file, we'll for the markdown, going to say contents to the. Now, what write file is going to take in? It needs to take in the name of the new file. So we'll say javascript.md. We will, for the second argument, say, what do we want to write to this file? So we'll say md.trim to trim off any extra white spaces from this string. Then we're going to create a function. And this callback function is going to log. Let's see that the mark is created.
Mm-hmm. Everybody get your ass back when they got one, then we got one. Wow, niggas, where they down, no. frontier. I tried to picture clusters of information as they moved through the computer. What did they look like? Ships, motorcycles. Were the circuits like freeways? I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day, I got it. We'll be right back. frontier. I tried to picture clusters of information as they moved through the computer. What did they look like? Ships, motorcycles. Were the circuits like freeways? I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day, I got in. Frontier.